This certainly looks like a more colorful Maggi here. I love this. What is that one Maggi that I should definitely try?
Habanero chili cheese.
Habanero chili cheese. Yes. That certainly is a spicy Maggi. That's a Nutella with some chocolate, hazelnut and chocolate. Hi folks, this is Kripal Amana, Gourmet on the Road, and you're watching Food Lovers TV. I hope you're doing well. Well, today I've set out for an impromptu tasting. I've been thinking of noodles for a while, and more specifically I've been thinking of Maggi for a while. I don't remember the last time I tasted Maggi, perhaps decades ago. I know that makes me sound really old, but I think my earliest memories of Maggi are when I was in college or so, or perhaps a little after that, where if you wanted to rustle up a snack, well, Maggi came to the rescue. And also, as you got more proficient at cooking that Maggi, you also started experimenting with various other things. So I remember I would put some eggs in it, some sausages, put some sauce and whatnot. And I think to many of us, that steaming bowl of Maggi brings back many memories. Memories from long ago. And I've heard of this tiny eatery, I think it's called Blue Wagon, that does some interesting iterations of the ever popular Maggi. So today we've set out to this eatery in Jayanagar, South Bengaluru, to relive some memories from my growing up years. You're the owner?
Yes.
What's your name?
Ipsa.
So you and your husband
run the place.
What's your husband's name?
Hitesh. We started with a food truck in 2017.
Okay.
We used to park near my yard in Jayanagar.
Okay.
Yeah.
And Blue Wagon?
Yes, it was called the Blue Wagon. It was a blue colored truck.
And how long did you run that?
About a year. I'm an architect. My husband is an engineer. We started this out of passion.
Okay.
Both of us quit our jobs, and our friends encouraged us, our families encouraged us that you're good at cooking, you should. And we used to cook for house parties and everything. So that's why Maggi and sandwiches came first.
Okay.
Then over the years, we experimented with other dishes. All the recipes you see here are our own. At the food truck, we just had butter garlic, chili cheese and juicy veggies. Three items, that's
okay.
It. And then we added a few burgers, and then other Maggis came along.
That's interesting. What Maggi is that?
Chili cheese.
Chili cheese?
Yeah.
Is that your favorite?
Yeah, this is my favorite. We love experimenting with different ingredients. That's why we get the habanero and ghost pepper from Bombay.
I can see there's some bhoot jolakya Maggi as well.
Yeah.
So I guess if you have a spicy palate.
That is if you can tolerate too much chili, only then.
Exceptionally hot.
Yes.
And I like the fact that it says there with 4 exclamation marks. Exceptionally hot. And then you have
habanero.
The habanero.
Habanero is a must try. It's a very spicy chili, but very flavorsome too.
And I think habanero also has a slight sweet edge. Is there a slight sweet edge?
A tangy taste.
A tangy taste. And who does the cooking?
Usually my husband, but
okay.
Since he's not around, me and the helper, we are managing.
Can I take a look?
Yes, come.
Oh, I like this. This is a nice, compact-sized kitchen.
Yeah.
And of course, I don't think I've seen Maggi ever in that quantity, even in supermarket shelves. Huh? So you can see sacks of Maggi out here. You know, when you talk about Maggi, everybody knows how to cook Maggi, or everybody thinks they know how to cook Maggi. So what makes it different here?
At the Blue Wagon, I think the ingredients that we mix with the Maggi, the flavors like tomato basil cheese. Nobody has ever made a tomato basil cheese or tomato basil mushroom Maggi. Usually if you go to any joint at hill station, you'll find chili cheese and
correct.
Veg Maggi, egg Maggi, like that. we experiment with different ingredients.
And that's what makes it interesting.
Yeah.
And is it still the same 2 minute wala Maggi recipe?
No, it takes 10-15 minutes.
10-15 minutes.
Yeah. Everything is vegetarian.
Everything is vegetarian. So there's no chicken Maggi here.
No.
So the taste makers that Maggi gives is the vegetarian taste maker.
Yes, yes.
And that is only the beginning of it. And then you add your own ingredients.
Yes.
What is that one Maggi that I should definitely try?
Habanero chili cheese.
Habanero chili cheese. Yes. So let's do the habanero chili cheese Maggi.
Yeah.
You got some habanero chilies, butter and the taste maker.
Yeah.
How does the experimenting happen? Do you kind of think or?
Usually yes. If we find a new ingredient in the market, then we make something new with it.
And you experiment with customers and before you decide to put it on the menu?
Yes. But with Maggi now we've stopped experimenting. Now we're shifting to other dishes too, like salads and wraps. If we have a bigger kitchen in future, we can keep a lot of other things.
Thank you. So I think when you come to the Blue Wagon Kitchen, as the name suggests, it's mostly the kitchen. So you come here, order your Maggi or whatever else have you, eat your food and leave.
So whenever you have the sauce, you don't feel it that much because the sauce will have 30%, 40% of the chili and less other things will be vinegar and all that. But here it's the actual chili, so you're going to feel it in every bite.
So Ipsa says I'm going to feel the habanero in every bite. Let's go for it. That poor fork, disposable fork, is being weighed down by the weight of the Maggi and the cheese and some of the other things that have gone into it. I can definitely taste some chili at the tip of my tongue. That certainly is a spicy Maggi. I want to taste some of that habanero just by itself. Do you think I'm being brave when I do that? I think I'll go for a little bit because Ipsa's reaction there seems to suggest that I should not attempt this. So I'm going to search for a teeny weeny bit of the habanero somewhere there. So it's got the spice, but the spice is cocooned in the pulpy fleshiness of that habanero. So I think typically when you're tasting a habanero sauce, and as I've learned from Ipsa here, is that you're tasting a lot of other ingredients that go into the sauce. The vinegar, the emulsifiers, the stabilizers and what have you. But out here, you're tasting the spice of that pepper, but in its moist, pulpy medium. And I think that's interesting.
It'll adjust to your palate in a while and then you'll want more.
Then you will want more. And then of course you also have the cheese that tones down or actually smothers some of the spice in its embrace. But then if you want things a lot more pointed, if you want things a lot more punchy, a lot more tikha, go for that ghost pepper and cheese Maggi here. So maybe my next one should be a tomato basil with mushrooms perhaps. Yeah, so I'll do that too.
Okay.
You know, I've ordered for another Maggi too. Just so that I can taste something different. But truth be told, you have one of these. You pretty much full up because this is not just the plain old Maggi and the seasoning. There's the cheese that's gone into it. There's plenty of butter that goes into it. The butter that the chili and the habanero is sorted in before the Maggi goes in. So this certainly is a Maggi that's quite indulgent. I can definitely feel that chili on the tip of my tongue. Thank you. Well, I definitely need some water to come to my rescue. What happens if you add some garlic to this? Can you do that?
To your Maggi?
Yeah. Thank you. This certainly looks like a more colorful Maggi here. I'm already sold on its visual appeal. And of course, I think in this one, we've also asked for some garlic. So they do a very popular butter garlic Maggi and I've read about that. So I said, let's add some garlic to our tomato basil with mushroom Maggi. I love this. I love the refreshing bite and the aroma of the basil and also the sweet acidity of the tomatoes. I haven't bitten into a mushroom yet, but I can already taste the umami flavor of the mushroom. that the mushroom releases as it's tossed, sauteed in that butter. So out here the Maggi and the ingredients that go into it are first sauteed in some butter. And like they say, butter makes everything better. You know, this is a plate that I'm really enjoying. The first one that I tasted is also great, but then you need a palate that is accustomed to spice. There are some of you who may be accustomed to a lot of spice. For you, the Bhut Jolakya Maggi is what you should have. For me, I appreciate subtlety in some of the flavors, and that's where this plate does the job for me. What I also like is that the Maggi is cooked just right. It's neither underdone nor is it overdone. It's not mushy in the least. You know, my earliest memories of Maggi are when we would rustle it up as a 2-minute snack. So all that you had was the noodles and of course the broth that the taste maker turned the water into. And if you had some eggs in the refrigerator, you scrambled some and that too went into the Maggi. So that was quite frugal, but in comparison to that, this almost seems like a luxurious version of a childhood memory. And I like the garlicky hit in this plate of Maggi. This is a plate that I could happily finish. So it's Maggi, pizzas, sandwiches, burgers,
toasts, garlic bread, fries, and fresh coffee.
I think you take your coffee rather seriously when I look at the AeroPress.
We started this in 2020. So during the lockdown, we were at home. So we started doing courses for fresh coffee, manual brewing basically. So AeroPress, cold brew, pour over, French press, mocha pot, all that.
Nice. And where do you get your coffee from? I can see one Ethiopian. Where does the rest of the coffee come from?
Others are from Chikmagalur.
From Chikmagalur. Yeah. What should I close with?
Another dish?
No, not another dish. Coffee? I think the current weather would be nice. Yeah. So what should I?
Try iced pour over. It's very good.
An iced pour over. Yeah. Let's do that. Well, I'm done with the Maggi. Time to go for some coffee. Mm-hmm. And this is a pour over. Iced pour over. And that's the Ethiopian medium roast.
Yeah. So in Ethiopian, the coffee notes, you can taste them very finely. And especially because it's medium roast. In light and medium roast, you tend to get all the flavors of coffee. But as soon as you move towards darker roast, it gives a more like a caramel note.
I can already smell the aroma of that coffee. You have the Maggi at one end of the spectrum, which is simple comfort food. Yeah. And then you've got coffee, which is made like how a connoisseur would appreciate coffee.
Yeah. It's been a long time since we've been talking about having coffee on our menu. But then we could not because of less space. Earlier, the partition was a little behind.
Okay.
And people used to come and sit inside.
Oh, okay.
So after COVID, we expanded the kitchen and nobody could
can come
there
inside.
Was no space. That's when we decided now we can have a coffee counter.
Ah. Thank you. Well, you can also end with some cupcakes here.
That is Nutella. It's our bestseller.
Oh, that's the bestseller.
Yes.
Nutella.
It has a Nutella filled inside the cake too. Oh. And in the frosting. So.
Fantastic. And this one?
This is caramel.
Caramel. So you can also end on the cupcake. But I think we'll end with the iced pour over, the Ethiopian coffee. This is probably the gentlest coffee that I have ever tasted. But I think this is a perfect coffee for the weather now. It's quite hot and sweaty. And I think for that, this Ethiopian pour over works just fine. If I were to try this coffee the next time around, I'd probably do a version of the coffee where the coffee is extracted with heat. And that would perhaps be an AeroPress. Because I think the ice also works to suppress some of the coffee notes. But then there are times when you don't really want to be tasting too much of the coffee. Well, if you wanted to do that, you'd probably be tasting a hot coffee. But this works more as a refreshing coffee to end your meal here at the Blue Wagon. But I'm quite tempted by the word Nutella. So maybe we'll taste a bit of the Nutella cupcake. Thank you. That's the Nutella with some chocolate, hazelnut and chocolate. I think this has been an interesting tasting. I set out to taste an austere childhood memory, the Maggi, which I certainly did taste. And then we moved up a few notches to that Ethiopian pour over. And now we're truly ending things on a decadent high with this Nutella cupcake. Well, that was an interesting meal here at the Blue Wagon Kitchen. It's fascinating to learn of people's passion for doing interesting things. Here's a couple, Ipsa and Hitesh, who were passionate about the idea of beginning a food truck, that they gave up their corporate careers to pursue their dream. So it began with a food truck called the Blue Wagon. The Blue Wagon has evolved into a tiny eatery called the Blue Wagon Kitchen. And they have dreams of making it bigger. So if you want to check out Maggi in a whole new avatar, very different from the memories that you and I perhaps have of eating Maggi decades ago, do look up the Blue Wagon Kitchen. I found the tomato mushroom Maggi most interesting. If you have a tolerance for spice, do try the fresh habanero chili Maggi as well. And if you really like things spicy, well, that Bhoot Jula Kya, the ghost chili, comes highly recommended. And they also take their coffee very seriously, so that's something that you could consider as well. And if you have a decadent sweet tooth, try the Nutella cupcake. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Gourmet on the Road. Until the next time, take care, stay safe, and happy eating. Bye-bye. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As, and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!